Hi everybody, just want to make this real quick video note and say thank you for your comments and feedbacks on the time-lapse tutorial videos. Really excited to invest some of those thoughts and ideas into the next series, and just can't thank you guys enough for your feedback. I'm also excited to share a new resource I've been working on, something I hope will be really helpful. It's called Time-lapse Photography, an introduction to shooting, processing, and rendering time-lapse movies with a DSLR camera. I've had a lot of fun making it, and it's designed for a new or intermediate DSLR shooter and time-lapse photographer. I just kind of want to go through real quick what's inside, and I hope it'll become a helpful resource for you guys. The first thing we talk about is a real quick introduction to time-lapse. We talk a little bit about the history, where time-lapse came from, and what sets time-lapse apart from other cinematography art forms. Then we get right into the gear that's required, both the minimum amount, and then we kind of introduce some of the advanced gear that you might consider building or purchasing down the road. Now, no worries if you're new to time-lapse. There really isn't much gear that's required to get started. I think you'd be surprised, and we'll cover the minimum amount of gear that you need. Then we talk about image settings and quality and resolution, and basically how you can fit all those time-lapse images onto your DSLR camera. Then we get into the meat of the book, which is shooting time-lapse sequences. We talk about some tips on creating a good composition. What are some of the ways you can balance speed and flow by choosing the right time-lapse interval and time-lapse settings. And then, of course, we talk about different exposure modes and ways that you can avoid flicker. And then, actually, we invested an entire chapter into time-lapse flicker. What are the different sources? Why does it occur? Both through camera exposure settings and through mechanical inconsistencies. And we go through in detail all the different ways that you can prevent, and then if it does occur, correct for it in post-production. Then we talk about creating the time-lapse movie itself. We'll go through three different workflows. The first is a free open source workflow using Virtual Dub for PC and then Timelapse Assembler for Mac. Then we'll talk about LR Timelapse in the Lightroom workflow. And then we'll also do a third workflow following Adobe After Effects in the Adobe Creative Suite. Then we get into my favorite part of the book, which is the time-lapse challenges section, where we really kind of test your understanding of some of these topics that we talked about. We'll shoot time-lapse of the night sky and create an astrolapse, talk about low-light shooting and the rule of 600, how to prevent stars from streaking, and we'll talk about some rendering tips to reduce noise after we take the sequence. Then we'll talk about the time-lapse holy grail, which is shooting from a full day to full night or full night from full day. We'll talk about a couple different ways that we can accomplish that, both with tethered shooting and GB time-lapse, to advanced intervalometers, to an LR time-lapse kind of solution in there too. Then we'll talk about creating an HDR time-lapse. What are the ways that we can create a pseudo HDR sequence using single images, or create a more of a standard real HDR sequence using bracketed multiple exposures. Then we'll give a brief introduction to time-lapse motion control devices, sliders and panning and tilting. And we'll kind of take the pulse of where some of the latest advances are out there. Making this resource. I hope it's something that's really helpful for you guys. I've got a lot of great feedback in on it already, and I'm excited to hear your thoughts and comments, and I'd love to see some of the time-lapse videos you create. Thanks.